Hi everyone, this is a really quick Baker's Twine comparison between three different companies, Baker's Twine. Now these three manufacturers do sell Baker's Twine by itself. There are some other brands that sell Baker's Twine in a collection with other ribbons or things like that, but these are companies that sell them individually by color or in packs with multiple colors. So the first one I'm going to talk about is Doodlebug, and they sell their Baker's Twine on cards like this, and they also sell them in little tiny spools by individual color. Now that's pretty much, you know, they have a bunch of different color packs. Red, I just have a few. So they're a really good option if you want to just try a bunch of different colors and kind of get a taste for your Baker's Twine stuff. The other one that I use quite a bit is from Martha Stewart Crafts, and I don't even have these in original packaging because I've used so much of them, but this particular pack came with two red, two brown, and two green, and they come in a little clear plastic box. In fact, I have the box. They're just not all in there. This is what the box looks like. Hi, Manny. Do you like Martha Stewart twine? Yeah? Okay. Okay, he's putting in his vote. So, this is the Martha Stewart twine. She does have some, or the brand, it's not just her. She does have some that sold with just the red and white, and it's a larger package. Another brand is the Twinery, and I know there's a bunch of other Baker's Twine out there, but the Twinery is really well known throughout the crafting industry, especially because they sell really large spools of Baker's Twine. So it's really great for packaging, you know, for presents or things like that. And they also have a really wide range of colors. Like, I really like stone and I really like Caribbean. I think those colors are so pretty, especially if you're going to be like doing some kind of traditional packaging that you would use Baker's Twine with like some craft wrapping paper or something like that. I also really like their cappuccino color. It's a little bit more of a soft brown as compared to the Martha Stewart Crafts, which is more of a brown. So now I'm going to compare the three side by side and show you the differences. And I'm going to tie all of them on some craft cardstock, and then I'll zoom in so you can see up close what they're like. Okay, I thought I would compare the reds because that's the color that is consistent across all of them, that there is a red offered. Versus Doodlebug, the ratio of white to red or white to the other color is pretty even. And it also has a really soft, fuzzy feel compared to the other ones, and you'll see this in a minute. This, to the other Baker's Twine, is clothing washed with fabric softener versus non-fabric softener. It just has a softer, more fuzzy feel. To me, it doesn't look like the traditional Baker's Twine, you know, that we're used to seeing on packages and, you know, where the name comes from, like bakery boxes and things like that. It seems a little bit more, I don't know, it just seems more fuzzier, like almost like a fine art versus a cartoon, but that seems like a really unfair comparison. I don't know. It has a little more bulk to it. It's just fuzzy. The next one is Martha Stewart, and hers is definitely the most dainty. The ratio of white to red, there's a lot more white than red. I would say maybe 1/3 red to 2/3 white. And it really does feel like string. It's really fine and thin, and it ties really well, and it's really nice. I really like that one. The Twinery, I would say, has the most traditional Baker's Twine feel. It's not as soft as Doodlebug. It feels more like just regular twine or string. And it really is like the traditional two colors of string wrapped around each other. And the color, the red, is a little bit more intense. So that's the comparison. I would have to say for your money, you're best to go with the Twinery because you're going to get a lot per yard. Or you're not going to pay as much per yard, I mean. And if you have a bunch of crafting buddies and friends that you all want to go in together on buying these, I think they're about, you know, a little over $14 a piece. You can split it between five people and, you know, $3, and you're getting like 50 yards per person. It's crazy because you get 240 yards. So there's that. As far as getting a bunch of colors all at once, the Twinery does offer some packs of pre-cut twine, you know, just down to a few yards instead of the 240, and you get multiple colors. Similar to what Doodlebug does, they give you 60 yards, so basically 10 yards of each color, and you get a bunch of different colors. We also have the smaller spools as well. Martha Stewart, as far as I know, she only has the pack of the six spools, the three colors of six spools, or the one red and white spool. I might be wrong on that. I haven't seen anything from her in a while when it comes to baker's twine, but I'm pretty sure she's gone the more traditional route and only offered it in red and white. That is my take on baker's twine. You can pick whichever one you like the most. As far as on cards, this is pretty dainty. I really like it because it is so dainty. The color over here is a little more intense. It's really enticing. And, you know, it's kind of the in-between these two. This one's a little more fuzzy and bulky, and this one's a little more dainty. This is kind of in-between. And you also get the most bang for your buck over here as well. So that's my comparison on baker's twine. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.